Greetings, East Valley staff, students, and families. I am Kayla Crow, East Valley High School principal, and it is an honor to welcome you to the Class of 2020 commencement ceremony. I'd like to begin our ceremony by acknowledging the hard work that the Class of 2020 has put in over the last 13 years to get to this momentous occasion. It is true that this year's graduation festivities look much different than years past and likely look much different than future graduations. However, seniors, do not let this take away from your accomplishments. These last 2 months have been an experience that adds to the one-of-a-kind nature that is the Class of 2020. This unprecedented time is shaping all of us, and although you may not want to think about this now, your class is making history. This is an experience that you will share with future generations as they look at you with admiration for the determination each of you has exhibited during one of the most uncertain times of our lives. I am proud of each of you, and it has truly been an honor to serve as your principal. Congratulations, Class of 2020.
Welcome. Thank you for taking the time to join us today. I know this is not the graduation ceremony that any of us had planned. In this time of uncertainty, it is easy to focus on all the things that you were not able to do. But instead of doing that, I want you to focus on all the things that you have been able to accomplish. You, the class of 2020, have pushed through and done it. You are graduating. You have shown the world that you are resilient, that you are persistent, and that you will find a way to get stuff done even when it is hard. As you enter this next phase in your life, remember this time. Remember how you found a way to keep going even when it seemed impossible. Remember how you made the choice to finish what you started even without knowing how this would all end. In closing, I want to say that I am proud of each one of you. Although I am sad that we are not celebrating this huge moment in your lives together, I want you to remember that you will always be a Red Devil and that you will always be part of the East Valley family. As you move into this next phase of your life, remember the people and the moments that you did get to share. And remember that this is just but one small thing that you will accomplish. And from here on out, I know that you will do great things. I miss you. Congratulations, Class of 2020.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. You made it. And what a journey you will be able to share with your future self and your family. Graduation speeches are all about giving advice and remembering what came before this monumental moment. What I'm going to do, or at least try to do, is stay away from the current event that we're all going through, and you know which one I'm talking about, and focus on giving the best advice that I can. Ultimately, I hope that you can find one small word or even a sentence to remember, and maybe it'll help you out. Congratulations, you are done with this part of the journey. Your educational career may be over. Some of you, many of you, have already started working 40 plus hours a week, turning a wrench, hospitality jobs, working in your family business. You're off and running. Thank you so much. I appreciate you, and so does the community. Others are getting ready to pursue a post-secondary education, college, the military, a trade school. Good luck, congratulations, and I appreciate you as well. There are also some of you who have no idea what you're going to do. Maybe you're just going to work. Maybe you continue to seek out opportunities. That is okay. Continue to work hard, and the reason you are here will soon present itself to you. And thank you. I appreciate you as well. Looking back at my 40 years, what I have learned is that service is something anyone can do. To give you some sort of perspective, when I went to college, I thought I knew what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. When I was in preschool, I was on a police motorcycle, and my mom took a really cool picture of me. And when I got to college, I enrolled in every law class that I could. I was determined to become that police officer. But you know what? Sometimes life has its own path in mind. My entire family, minus my dad, who is an engineer, is in the education field. Sister, kindergarten teacher, other sister, math and science teacher at high school, mom, paraprofessional. What did I do? I became a teacher. But why? It just felt the thing to do. And I was right. I loved every single moment of it, teaching math and science, and I miss it tremendously. And as I transitioned to one of your assistant principals, it was another amazing move, and it was the right move for me to make. But something always sat in the back of my mind for 25 years, that picture of me on that motorcycle. What could I do? Did I make a mistake? What could I have been? And the problem is, I'm 40. It's not possible. I can't go back and be that police officer. But I did. I trained. I was knocked down a lot. My back's not good. I was exhausted. But I graduated that program. And today, at nights and on the weekends, I keep my community safe and shake a lot of hands. And I continue to learn every day. What is the lesson in this? Well, graduation speeches are all about lessons. And recall, I hope you can find something out of this. And one of the main ideas is this idea of service. Any of you can help or serve. It takes no money, very little of your time, and you do not need to be an expert at anything. Think about the last time you did something for someone. How did that make you feel? Probably pretty dang good. And how did that impact that person that you helped or that family? How did they feel? Can you find daily opportunities to serve others? A kind note, a text message, leave a treat on someone's doorstep, say hello to a friend, give a smile. There are so many opportunities to serve. And I will leave you with this. It's not about you. I can promise you that. You will be your absolute happiest when you put others first. The joy and happiness you feel when someone else is happy is immeasurable. I want to quickly thank all the teachers, the parapros, the custodial staff, the food services for doing their best during a very difficult year. You're very much appreciated, and I thank you. I care about you. To the parents and the siblings of our graduating seniors, congratulations to you as well. Seniors, congratulations on grinding out these 13 years of homework, speeches, essays, tests, labs, and projects. You did an amazing job, and I cannot wait to see what the future holds for you. Whatever you do, don't forget to serve. I mean, you could reach over right now, give a quick hug or a kiss to those people who helped you to this point. I have a feeling it would make their day. Almost forgot. Remember that picture that I talked about earlier? Well, here you go. Yep, that's little Mike on that motorcycle. And here I am, 35 years later or so, doing what I said that I wanted to do. Congrats, Red Devils. Now go serve, work hard, and do something that you love.
Welcome, friends, family, faculty, and soon-to-be graduates. Thank you to everyone who is here today to celebrate the class of 2020 on this unforgettable milestone. I would like to start by thanking my friends and family. First and most importantly, my parents. Mom and Dad, I thank you for everything you've done for our family and the unconditional love you have given me. I learned and continue to learn my sense of hard work and determination from none other than my parents. You will always be my biggest inspirations. I'd also like to thank my brother and sister for being there every step of the way and cheering me on. Another thank you goes to the incredible friends that I've made over the years. I'm simply grateful for the love and laughter that we have shared. And a big thanks to our teachers. Thank you for working so hard to get us here today, because it wouldn't be possible to be here without all of you. Now, I thought I'd bring up quarantine. It was something else. It was a time when people were making whipped coffee, dancing, singing, cooking, and making some more whipped coffee. We can all thank TikTok for the endless entertainment it brought to many people, which most definitely includes me. I'd be lying if I said my screen time on my phone didn't completely spike over the last couple months. We also can't forget the legendary graduation and class of 2020 memes. Outside of our little valley, there have been many unbelievable things that have happened. Here's a quick recap of 2020. World War III almost happened. Australia was on fire, Kobe Bryant passed away, the outbreak of COVID-19, March Madness was canceled, the NBA season was suspended, and we're still dealing with the repercussions of the continuing epidemic. We made it through all of that, and who knows what's more to come in the future. Who knows? Maybe dinosaurs will be making a comeback of their own. There's a memorable quote I found, and it goes, "Never regret a day in your life. Good days give happiness, bad days give experience, worst days give lessons, and best days give memories." The good days were when we started high school, a new part of our life. We walked through the halls, seeing our friends every day. We would look forward to the Friday night lights, spirit weeks, game days, school dances, and the best part of the day, which was always lunch. In those moments, we made countless memories that we'll always have to look back at. Bad days can be remembered by the ongoing construction. Some of us had to hike to the North Building every day. I mean, who doesn't enjoy walking through wind, rain, or mud, especially while wearing white Vans, Air Forces, or sandals? Or feeling the random vibrations and pounding in the middle of class. And there was always a time when all our teachers would team up and decide on a week to load all the students with a whole bunch of work. Specifically, Mr. and Mrs. Morrison come to mind. The worst days were when we found out we wouldn't be getting our traditional senior year. So many of the things we'd been looking forward to were being canceled. We also didn't know that March 13th would be our last normal day of being a high schooler. And now, we're living through a global pandemic. The best days are when we accomplish remarkable things. We have all worked extremely hard to get to where we are today. We are getting our diplomas, and that's no small accomplishment. Our best days also lay in the future. We all have goals to reach, passions to find, and careers to pursue. Leading up to today, we've overcome tough and unthinkable obstacles. Graduates, I hope you follow your dreams, strive to be the best versions of yourselves, and above all, do what makes you happy. I wish nothing but the best for everyone. Class of 2020, we finally made it. Hashtag devil till I die. Hashtag go big red. Hashtag East Valley. Hashtag go fight win. Hashtag EVHS. Hashtag class of 2020. Hashtag we did it. Thank you and congratulations, graduates.
Welcome friends, family, teachers, and of course, class of 2020. Although you are most likely watching from a phone or computer screen, I'd still like to thank you all for joining me in the celebration of our graduating class. It's been over 10 years of hard work and determination that got us here, and it couldn't have been done without all the help and support from everyone. Thank you to the staff members who have dedicated so much time to each and every one of us, quite possibly losing your minds just as much as we have, if not more. We all know it's been one heck of a year, but none of us would be here today if it weren't for you. Thank you to the family members who have given us nothing but love and support. And thank you to all of our friends for helping us keep our sanity and maybe giving the answers to a few assignments here and there. We all know high school isn't easy, but without the help of all of you, it wouldn't have been possible. So once again, thank you. Before reaching high school, we all had expectations of what it would be like based off of Mean Girls, High School Musical, and for some, The Breakfast Club. But unfortunately, we quickly realized that on Wednesdays you don't have to wear pink, and singing throughout the cafeteria during school isn't the norm. Being in high school doesn't mean you have to be the most popular or the best looking. It means you work together with the people around you to accomplish great things and make unforgettable memories with the 4 years you're given. We're still young, not yet to the years of hard responsibilities and countless bills, so make these years fun while you can. Someday, when we're 40 years old, we aren't going to remember the English lesson we learned on Friday, 23 years ago, no offense, Kima. But we will remember the sports games we attended and the excitement we felt when reaching districts and the state tournament. We will remember the pep assemblies and how good we felt when our class won the competitions. These memories are the ones you will never forget, which is why, if I could give one piece of advice to all the underclassmen, it would be to just relax and enjoy your time. Don't stress over that English book report or DEMO's pre-calc final. Trust me, I got a C- on that test, and I'm still the salutatorian of my class. Make sure to take time for yourself and be with the people who make you better. From experience, I learned that having friends who push you to be better and improve make it 100 times easier. I wouldn't have done as good in school if it weren't for the help and support of my friends. It may seem hard, and I know it feels like the work will never end, but it does. You will graduate too, and just like me, you'll wish your life was as easy as it was in high school. which is why taking that time to have fun and enjoy yourself is so important. Over the past 4 years, I have learned that while it may be frustrating to receive so much work from your teachers, it's only there to help us. Their sole purpose in working is to guide each and every one of us to a successful and happy life. I have gained a substantial amount of respect for all my teachers over the years, going from hating when I had to go to class to actually appreciating the fact that they invest so much time into us, really caring about our futures. Even though they are getting paid to teach us, we don't realize the amount of times they go in early, stay late, or even give up their lunches to help us. These important people not only teach curriculum lessons, but also very important life lessons. For example, we learned from Mr. Detloff that failure is how you succeed. From Mrs. Pedersen, we learned that being kind and including others, no matter who they are, will take you very far in life. And last, but most certainly not least, we learned from Dima, don't ask stupid questions. Whether the lessons were big or small, we appreciated them all. And the teachers who taught them are the reason we are graduating today. Before I conclude my speech, I would like everyone to know how proud I am that despite all the challenges thrown at us this year, we have stayed strong and gotten through it successfully. There are so many things we didn't get to experience as seniors this year, but we kept our heads high and made it to the end. I also want to thank the staff for making it as special for us as you could and working hard to give us what we would have missed out on. It's so surreal that we are finally done and moving on to the next chapters of our lives, but it makes it so much more rewarding knowing how hard we have worked for it. Every class has things they are remembered for, but I know one thing's for sure. Our class will leave behind a legacy that will never be forgotten, and I am so happy to be a part of it. Thank you.
When they told us that senior year flies by, they really weren't joking. It truly was the most unforgettable year of our high school career. Well, class of 2020, we finally made it. And although that's a very common phrase to start off every graduation speech with, I think the class of 2020 really were the ones to make it. I mean, who would have thought that we'd be graduating via Chromebooks in our living room and possibly receiving our high school diploma through a PDF file? Who would have thought that we'd be starting our senior year off in a construction zone and then have our brand new gym set on fire, followed by having school canceled for 2 days because our old school was falling apart? Who would have thought all the senior athletes would have their spring sports season canceled because of a global pandemic? Who would have thought prom, Tolo, Mysteries Valley, pep assemblies, and all those senior events we look forward to so much would be scratched? If I'm being honest, I don't think any of us pictured our senior year to look quite this way. While these circumstances have been quite upsetting and unfortunate, I do not want that to be the focus of tonight. Tonight is about everything we did accomplish, and it is about the seniors in our class that made our last 4 years of high school so unforgettable. I'd like to first start off with our band and cheer team. They were our biggest supporters. You could always rely on seniors such as Sophie Crows, Levi Pearson, Jackie Coy, Spencer Malmberg, and other senior band kids to be at every home football game. Regardless of the weather conditions, these seniors always supported our East Valley athletes through the music they played and practiced so hard for. With every loss or win, you could always rely on senior cheerleaders like Jazzy Gill to rise and shout for our fellow Red Devil athletes. We appreciate you all. To all our senior athletes, thank you for representing the East Valley community through your passion for sports. I'd like to especially recognize our boys basketball team, including the seniors Jordan Hooper, Marcos Carrillo, and Ryan Sullivan. Due to construction, these guys had to travel all the way to Wapato for their home basketball games. Even though this wasn't the most ideal situation, these boys didn't let this stop them from playing their hearts out. Jaden Silv, if there's anyone that knows how to persevere through sports, it's you. I mean, who would have thought sophomore year of PE that I, Alexa Miller, a tiny scrawny girl, would end up breaking your leg in a harmless game of capture the flag football? All jokes aside, Jaden, you're an outstanding football player, and I have no doubt that you will accomplish great things in your future. I truly, truly wish you good luck, and as all the actors tell each other, break a leg. Well, to all the seniors that knew how to brighten our days, Brock Albright, Matthew Bombard, and Jared Sires, it didn't matter if you were reading the most boring book in the world or procrastinating our long Macbeth essays, you three would always find ways to make KMO's third period class smile and laugh. The legend himself, Robbie Kershaw. Robbie, I can't remember a time where you haven't made me smile. You are by far the best boys basketball manager that East Valley will ever have.
If there is anyone that has spirit, pride, and excellence, it is 100% you. To all the seniors that worked their tails off, we have seniors like Kayla Gout, Harrison Bissonette, Luis Soto, Desmond Ramos, Haley Leach, Kylie O'Neill, and countless others that attended the high school, YBC, Perry Tech to pursue their goals, whether it was to obtain an associate's degree or striving to go after a specific career path. These seniors did not let anything stand in their way from accomplishing their goals. We also had many hardworking seniors that held part-time jobs in order not only to provide for themselves, but their families. They had to learn how to balance a job with school, family, and whatever life threw at them. Your guys' strength during difficult times will only continue to help you progress in life. To the seniors that expressed kindness to all, Mackenzie Mabee, Moses Alexander, Javen Morrison, Riley Davis, Megan St. John, Gabriella Byers, Erica Garcia, Bailey Rogers, and so many more. It didn't matter who you were or where you were from, these seniors knew how to make you feel loved and important. Even if it was a simple smile in the hall or hey, how are you doing, their actions will have a lasting impact on the lives of so many. Every single senior in our class has shown at one point or another what it's like to be a true East Valley Red Devil. Yes, we are not perfect. We have all had moments where we have felt like we are drowning in our own trials and struggles. We have had times where we felt like we failed ourselves, whether it was in sports, school, home, and the list could go on. But to me, I believe that there is beauty found in every shortcoming. It all depends on the lenses you wear and how you choose to see it. Don't get me wrong, we have every right to feel sad and upset about how things turned out for our class. But we didn't lose everything. We still got those 13 years from when we were tiny kindergartners all the way to when we became big grown-up seniors. And no one, not even COVID-19, can take away those 13 years filled with so many memories. Memories of when we were little kids playing on the playground or learning how to tie our shoes for the first time. Moxie Elementary kids having to share their playground with Terrace Heights, attending awkward middle school socials, movie nights with Kamo's delicious brownies, and so many more. Our East Valley senior boys still got to raise money for Children's Village Youth Works Foundation. On Friday the 13th, how convenient, in March, we took our senior prank to a whole new level this year and got a pandemic to cancel school for us. We got the most senior skip days in history. Good luck, a class of 2021, for trying to beat that. But most importantly, seniors nationwide got a free box of Krispy Kreme donuts. I mean, it can't get better than that. We still get to graduate. I know it's not how any of us would like to do it, but because of today, we are getting one step closer to our goals. Lastly, we got to go through all of it together. We never had to experience it alone. Thousands of seniors nationwide, class of 2020, don't let these difficult moments determine your happiness, because they don't. I'd like to thank my crazy but wonderful family of mine who have been nothing but supportive and loving to me. Thank you for teaching me how to relax and not just endure life, but to enjoy it. I love you guys. Thank you to all my teachers that helped further my education. You believed in me when I didn't believe in myself. I couldn't have done it without you guys. I'm especially thankful to God. He has been my anchor through all this, and he will continue to be by my side for every second that I live and beyond. The truth is, I owe it all to him. Lastly, I'd like to thank class of 2020. I am beyond thankful for all the friendships that I was able to make and for the memories you all gave me. Thank you for these last 13 years. I wouldn't trade them for the world. I know this isn't the high school musical fantasy that you all imagined it to be, but as Troy Bolton once said, we're all in this together. Go Devils.
If you told me that during the first week of school that this is what our graduation would look like, I wouldn't have believed you. And it's still hard to believe that this is how we're spending our final moments as seniors. Everyone works hard to reach this moment, but it took a much different level of work for us to get here. Even before school was closed, we had to deal with construction and walking between buildings and not having a gym. And after the closure, we had to find the motivation to do our classwork amongst the billions of distractions that working from home brought to us. We gave new meaning to the term senioritis, and honestly, it was more contagious than the virus. But in spite of the difficulties, we finally reached our graduation, a day that many of us have dreamed of, and even if it's not how we expected it, it's still an amazing triumph and marks the start of our adventure into adult life. I think at some point in every grad speech, it's an obligation to brag about how amazing your class is. I'm not going to say that our class is the best class in the history of East Valley to ever walk those halls, although if we're talking about the new building, we're technically the only class to ever walk those halls, so by default the best. There will never be a true way to determine who the best class is, but I know that our class is great because of how much it hurt when we found out we wouldn't be spending our final months together. Admit it, there was some point during the quarantine when you would have rather been at school. And I think it speaks volumes that high school seniors nationwide would have rather been at school. We didn't know how good we had it until we lost it. Let this be a lesson in maximizing our time. Live each moment to its full potential because they're always just a little shorter than you expect. I hope that when you look back on the 5.5 months we had together and the 12 years before that, that you're grateful for how you spent your time. Don't focus on the memories you didn't get to make, but be glad for the ones you did. Obviously, our graduation didn't happen the way we wanted it to. We didn't get to walk across that stage and receive our long-awaited handshakes and diplomas as our friends and families looked on. And it sucks that we couldn't do that, but this isn't the end for us. It was never going to be the end, even if things were normal. And it especially can't be the end now. Don't let this be the end. Go after your next goal. Reach your next milestone. Give yourself a stage to walk across, literal or otherwise. I wanted to leave off with a quote that has spoken to me a lot throughout this year as we prepared for this moment. I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them and we help them in return. According to the quote, we became friends with the people who would influence us the most. We all rubbed off on each other somehow. We left imprints on each other's personalities. A major part of high school is figuring out who you are as a person, or rather, becoming who you're meant to be through these interactions. Never minimize the importance of these interactions, because you'll never know the impact they can have on yourself and on others. We helped mold each other into incredible people capable of amazing things. So wherever life takes you, don't just leave your mark on the world, leave our mark. Our crazy, construction-filled, quarantine-riddled, uniquely beautiful East Valley Class of 2020 mark. Thank you.
Never forget you. You always be by my side. you aren't familiar. I could get used to this. Time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. There's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. We're south of the equator, navigator. Gotta hit the road, gotta hit the road. Deep sea diving round the clock, bikini bottoms, lager tops. I could get used to this. Time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. There's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. We got two in the front, two in the back, sailing along. Mountaintop that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember, when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever, and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feel like December, when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember, when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your.
Memories bring back your. Good evening. It is an absolute honor to be speaking in front of you tonight. This evening, we are graced by the presence of many incredible leaders, both from the East Valley School District and the greater East Valley community. I would like to take a moment to recognize a few of them for their tireless commitment to the students of East Valley. Mr. John Sheehy, Mr. Russ Hill, and the rest of the district office team. Mrs. Kayla Crow, Mr. Michael Martone, and Mrs. Stephanie Torpy, and the rest of the building leadership teams in the East Valley District. The East Valley School District Board of Directors. District Athletic Director, Mr. John Yount. All of the specialists, counselors, administrative and staff assistants, athletic and club coaches, and all of the people who work tirelessly to keep our campuses clean and beautiful. And finally, to all of the teachers. The students of East Valley are very fortunate to have such great teachers and role models. Thank you all. Now to the class of 2020. Wow, what a crazy senior year. From construction and moving issues throughout the year, to an impeachment trial, on to a serious global pandemic, and right into the turbulence and wake of the George Floyd murder. But there was one constant amongst all the uncertainty this year. Something that I recognized about this group early on, and that is your ability to persevere and overcome. Like maybe no class before you, the class of 2020 has been challenged. However, rather than run from those challenges, as nobody could blame you for at this age, you have faced them and not only kept battling, you have become stronger in the process. It's quite remarkable to witness, and you should be proud of yourselves because it's a demonstration of the incredible character that you have. It is one of the words that I used in the last sentence that I would like to take some time to talk about tonight. That word is character. Character is who you are based upon many distinct character traits. Character is also something that can and should develop on an infinite level, meaning that you are always evolving as an individual. At this point, you might be asking yourself, what is Dennis rambling about this time? Yes, sixth period, I do have a point here. I chose to focus on the word character because of the incredible character the class of 2020 possesses. So why is character so important then? Well, it defines each of us and everything that we do, how we treat ourselves, how we treat others, our output of effort into something, and the list goes on. Character is everything. I believe character is developed by the choices we make every day. At least by adulthood, we, as individuals, have a choice on the type of person we are and want to grow into. We make a choice about the attitude we are going to have when we start our day. We make a choice about how we treat others. We make a choice about what we want to define as success. We make a choice on the amount of effort we put into achieving our goals. We make a choice on if and how we give back to the community that we are a part of. All of these choices become character traits of who we are as individuals and ultimately define us as members of a community, family, and amongst our friends. Something else I would like to talk about is community. When I applied to East Valley, I knew very little about the community. While I waited for my application to be processed and ultimately got the call to interview, I did some research and learned about the type of place that it is. As I gathered information about the district, area, and the people who make up the community, I got really intrigued and excited about the possibility of joining such a diverse, hardworking, and connected community. Despite interviewing in two other districts prior to my interview at East Valley, I was secretly hoping that East Valley would be the first district to offer me a job. The day I got the call, I was in class in the district I came from. I missed the call, but saw it shortly after. Yes, I looked at my cell phone in class, don't act like any of you haven't done it, on a daily basis, about 100 times every 45 minutes. Anyway, I checked the voicemail and got the great news that I was offered the job that was at the top of my list. While I only knew one person when I moved to Yakima almost 2 years ago, I knew that I was coming to a place where people are filled with love, acceptance, a strong sense of community, and a place where diversity is not only celebrated, but a crucial character trait that makes East Valley and the greater Yakima area the incredible communities that they are. Upon my arrival to town, the class of 2020 and the rest of the community brought me in as one of your own. We've had so many incredible times together in the classroom, on the field, and in the hallways. Some of you I have even run into around town or while playing tennis at the park. I still want my rematch, George. All of these are memories that will be with me forever, and the lifelong bonds that you have formed this year and throughout your time at East Valley are just that, lifelong. As you move on from high school, whether you stay in East Valley, Yakima, or move somewhere else, you will always be East Valley, and you represent East Valley wherever you go. Remember what that stands for. Remember the character you've developed in your time walking these hallways and sitting in these most uncomfortable desks. Those desks alone help develop some character, if not some permanent back problems. But remember what being a member of this community means. Carry that with you as you move into other communities. Get to know your neighbors. Welcome yourselves when you move in. Welcome others when they move in. Look after not only yourselves and your family, but also for those in your community. We should all want success for each other because that's a big part of what makes a community stronger. It's like football or any other sports team. You are only as strong as your weakest players. Strong teams get contributions from and share in the success with every member, from the maintenance crew to the trainer to the coaches to every last one of the players. The same goes for a community. A community where everyone lifts everyone up is a strong, successful community. Bring those up around you. Reach out to those in need. Make kindness normal. If we can do that as communities, it can only lead to progress and success for everyone. Of course, go out and get yours. Set goals, make them lofty but achievable, check them off as you complete them, and set new ones. Define success as whatever that means to you and go out and achieve it. The character you have shown as individuals and as a group leaves no doubt that you can be successful as you choose to be in this next stage of your lives. Never stop reflecting. Be able to look at yourself in the mirror and know that you are being true to yourself and to those around you. Know that you were always given your best effort in every aspect of your life. And always continue to grow as a person and refine your character because that's what you will be remembered for. As I have told you all year, graduating high school cannot be understated as an accomplishment, and you deserve to be recognized for that. However, for each and every one of you, it is far from the last or best of the accomplishments you will achieve. In closing, the last piece of advice I would like to pass on is find something that you love to do and make that into a career. It's cliche to say that if you love your job, it's not work, because it will be work, trust me. And the more you love it, the more effort you will put into it. Effort, one of those key character traits. But that's the beauty of it, because that passion ultimately brings out your best work and helps define our character. East Valley class of 2020, you've had it rough these last several months. The missed spring sports season, the missed senior activities, the health and societal issues, and so on. I can't say how sorry I am that those memories were taken away from you. However, as you have shown all along, you will take these experiences and make positives out of them as you move forward. Help inspire well-being and progress in your communities. You are incredible, hardworking, tough, talented, and most of all, amazing people. I will miss you all so much, and I look forward to hearing about all of your successes. From all of us in the district, please stay in touch and share your successes with us, and remember that we are always here for you in times of need. We love you, and congratulations.
Brock Albright. Moses Alexander. Hanin Elsarama. Brianna Anderson. Martiza Ayala. Yulisa Ayala. Avery Bailey. Amber Ballard. Ashton Ballard. Michelle Barbosa. Reynaldo Bautista. Tegan Beezer. Harrison Bissonette. Emily Blanchard. Matthew Bombard. Shania Boyd. Javen Browning. Eric Brumley. Trinity Buckingham. Gabriella Byers. Alex Calhoun. Octavio Camacho. Marco Cappy. Marcos Carrillo. Jared Castro. Jacob Changala. Matthew Church. Caleb Clayton. James Coble. Blake Cockrum. Risa Colazo. Jose Colazo. Brenda Contreras. Isaiah Contreras. Ramon Cordova. Brisenia Cortez. Jacqueline Coy. Trevor Crane. Diana Cruz Rivera. Levi Cruz. Raul Cruz. Daniel Cuevas. Raquel Cuevas. Austin Cully. Tyler Dan. Maggie Davis. Malia Davis. Riley Davis. Lydia Dawkins. Diego Dueñas. Logan Dukes. Rosalinda Escorza. Colton Fambro. Kevin Fonseca Espinoza. Corbin Franklin. Elizabeth Gallardo Moran. Erica Garcia. Giselle Garcia. Jesus Garcia Nolasco. Marcos Garcia. Jenia Garduno, Jasjot Gill, Abel Gomez, Adriana Gomez,
Chelsea Gonzalez, Galilea Gonzalez, Leonardo Gonzalez, Melissa Gonzalez, Rain Gonzalez, Sebastian Gonzalez, Alexandria Gonzalez Cervantes, Michaela Gordon, Kayla Gout, Jackson Graham, Alexander Groger, Aldo Guerra, Nicholas Gutierrez, Rebecca Gutierrez, Spiridon Heckler, Isabel Hampton, Raven Harmon, Brianna Harris, Darlene Helm, Yvette Hernandez Madrigal, Gloria Herrera, Joran Hooper, Emma Hopkins, Gina Hutchinson, Anai Ixta, Jaden Jacobs, Ryan Jones, Robert Kershaw, Skylin Clausen, Carter Klein, Sophia Crows, Michaela Kroll, Joseph Labernick Jr., Haley Leach, Casey Leslie, Andre Yerenas, Jacob Lopez, Jocelyn Luna Sanchez, Christian Magana, Carter Malenberg, Spencer Malenberg, Isaiah Martinez, Mackenzie Martinez, Christian Martinez Diaz, Mackenzie Maybe, Alyssa McGilvra, Dorian Medina, Jorge Medina, Jesus Mendoza, Joanna Mendoza, Alexa Miller, Mahila Moeller, Blanca Montiel Escavel, Jocelyn Moreno, Javen Morrison, Juanita Mosqueda, Sarah Moss. Stephen Newby. Danaya Newman. Kylie O'Neill. Rodrigo Olivas. Eric Arona. Sean Owens.
Angelica Paul. Levi Pearson. Nicholas Pearson. Slade Pelkey. Efren Pena. Jacqueline Perez. Jasmine Perez. Juliana Perez. Jenna Pimentel. Victor Pisano. Dakota Poirier. Devin Porter. Gabriel Ramirez Hermosa. Desmond Ramos. Quentin Ramos. Carl Randolph. Michaela Reed. Augusta Ryland. Dylan Rice. Alejandro Rodriguez. Haley Rodriguez. Ashley Rodriguez-Arenas. Jason Rodriguez-Rincon. Bailey Rogers. Gabriela Rojas. Trinity Rojas. Claudia Romo. Sandra Roque. Caden Rosencrantz. Leisha Sanchez. Yixella Sanchez. Daniel Sanchez Godinez. Perla Sanchez Mendoza. Logan Sandal. Tino Sandoval. Hannah Santos. Shane Schindler. Abigail Scully Ruiz. Jared Sires. Madison Sletton. Luis Soto. Kevin Soto Avalos. Emily St. George. Megan St. John. Denton Steen. Jarrett Sturbens. Caitlin Steiner. Brian Stout. Ryan Sullivan. Jaden Sill. Mackenzie Taylor. Diana Tello. Eli Thompson. Michael Toby. Kathy Lee Torres. Dylan Turner. Juan Vargas. Maria Velasquez Frias. Nisa Vickery. Luis Villa. Nicholas Villa. Elijah Walter. Trenton Weaver. Cade Wehrmeyer. Ashlyn Williams. Isaac Zuniga.
Will all of our graduates please rise? It is a long-standing tradition that after receiving the diploma, the cap tassel is shifted from the right side to the left side of the cap. Graduates, please move your tassels. Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, I present to you the 2020 graduating class of East Valley High School.
Friends.